Good evening to everyone. Thank you so much for joining us. This is actually the first session, the first webinar for the ChooseTrans Store, the September session. And through this webinar, we will be talking a little bit about studies in France and the different application procedures for the public universities as well as the private institutions. So we are two of us here today in, for the first webinar. So I have my colleague with me, Yash, who is the Campus Trans Manager for Bangalore. And I am Shruti, who I'm the co-manager for the Campus Trans office in Chennai. So we will start right away. We will just take you quickly through studying in France and what the benefits for international students. We will touch a little bit about the visas, and then we'll move on in detail to the different application procedures on the Études en France portal. So yeah, one second. Okay. So when you think about France, what students or anybody usually thinks about is the culture, that is the most romantic city, the most romantic country, and you know, the different monuments, the architecture, the cuisine, the language. But France is also known for its high quality of education. It is one of the top destinations for international students, and each region and each city in France has its own culture and own heritage. And a major portion of why students go to study abroad or, you know, in France is to integrate into the country and to adopt a new way of living. So as much as the education is important, the lifestyle that you acquire and, you know, the perspectives that you gain from studying in France is equally important. So what is Campus France and who are we? So Campus France is basically a government agency. We fall under the French Embassy in India, and we are also under the French Ministry of Higher Education and Research, and also the French Ministry of External Affairs. And so we organize free counseling sessions. Right now it's virtual. We organize various workshops. We do the Choose France Tour twice a year. We have a France alumni network, which is a really large network with over 3,500 members. We help students study and pursue their education in France. So we help you right from the initial process. So right from your counseling sessions till the time you get your visa, we help you through every step of the process. So students come to us for counseling, for, you know, to help them, you know, build their study plan, to build their CV and their SOP. And we also offer a lot of advice on the courses that they take, and we guide them through each step till they reach France. And even we also organize pre-departure sessions for the students who are leaving and who are going to study in France. And we give them a little insight on, you know, what to expect when they reach there, the different administrative procedures, and basically how to make their life a little more easier when they are in France. So yeah, so what are the benefits that you have as a student in France? Something to note is that there is no discrimination between French students and international students who study in France. So you have access to the free social security, which is available to all students who are in France. Your tuition fees is heavily subsidized. So the French government spends around 14,000 euros per student per year, and a huge portion of this is subsidized by the French government. So you end up paying only one third of your tuition fees, which comes to around 3,770 euros. And the government also helps you in this process called CAF, which is the Caisse d'Allocation Familiale, which is the Family Allowance Fund, where they reimburse 30% of your rent. So if you're living in a private apartment or a studio, or, you know, and you can apply for the CAF and get 30% of your rent reimbursed. There is a student housing support called CRUS, which comes out to be a lot more cheaper than staying in a private residence. So these student residency halls, the applications to it open a lot earlier, and the government helps by providing really cheap accommodation, and which is accessible to international students as well as French students. And while you are studying in France with a student visa, you have the right to work part-time. So you can work up to 19.5 hours while you are studying. And you also have the right to earn while you work. So all work is paid in France. So this is a really good way to supplement your funds, because we understand that you are going to study in France on a budget. So working part-time is a great opportunity for you to earn a little extra money. And yes, so while you are in France as an international student, you get a lot of allowances and a lot of subsidies on a lot of things. So for example, public transport, you know, your libraries, cafeterias, museums, and there are certain days also in a week which is allotted only for students in certain places, like certain museums give you free access to students and you can go and visit that places. So there's a lot of initiatives that the French government takes to accommodate students, and it's given equal importance to both international students as well as to the French students. Yeah, so talking about the universities in France, so we have around 1,600 programs which are taught fully in English, and there are each student, there's so much of richness and diversity in the programs that we offer that any student will be able to find something that is according to their objectives and according to their study plans. So there are around 74 public universities, 220 business and management schools, around 200 engineering schools, 4 architecture schools. There is something also called the Grand École program, which is very unique to France. You can equate this to the Ivy League schools that you find in the US. So it's very allied, and you have students in France will have to go through preparatory courses, 2 years of preparatory courses to apply for a competitive exam in order to enter the Grand École. But for Indian students, you wouldn't have to go through that whole process. So you can directly access the Grand École, but it is really difficult to get in because it's highly competitive. But it's, if you get into it, you know that you are in the best of the best schools.
Thank you, Shruti. So speaking about the programs that you can choose, a lot of you might have the question on how to choose programs and how to go about the research. There are two ways you can do this. First of all, you can get in touch with your nearest Campus Funds office, and we will help you with the counseling according to your requirements. We will help you choose programs of your interest, and we will also help you with the process of application. There are other ways where you can do your own research, of course. There are certain program catalogs that are mentioned on our Campus Funds website. There are English taught programs where there's a link to it, which you can use, which it's on our website as well. You can use certain keywords to search for programs on this catalog. You can use the filters which are given on this website to filter out exactly what you are looking for. There are also short-term programs which you can consider for any sort of programs. Now, once you have selected a program or a university that you want to go to, there are two ways that you can go about it. If the university is a public university and if the university is a private university, there are two different ways of applying to these courses. We will be taking you through these courses, through these application procedures in detail in a few minutes. So you will get a better insight on how to go about the application process. Speaking about scholarships, of course, there is a dedicated webinar for scholarships, which is happening today at 6:30. So make sure you do attend that to gain more knowledge on what the different scholarships are, how you can apply for it, what are the benefits, and of course the deadlines of all of them. So you can log in at 6:30. You can view that webinar and understand better. Yeah. So of course, if you are going to study in France, knowing French is an added advantage for you. So of course, why you should know French? It basically allows you to go about your day-to-day life in France. You go through, you speak to the locals, complete your administrative procedures. And of course, this does help you in employment and internship opportunities as well. How you can learn the language is before you leave to France, before you apply to a university, you can do French language courses at the Alliance Française. It is located in all the major cities across India. Now, if you don't do a course in French, it's not mandatory because most of the courses that you will be applying for are English taught, and there is no need to have French as a prerequisite, but it is definitely beneficial. If you don't do a French course in India, you can do a French course with your institute. You will have to contact the international office of your institute and find out the details of the French course that they offer. You can also apply to the Alliance Française in France, depending on the region you are in, and complete certain French courses there as well. Speaking of the visas, so when you do apply for a program that is less than 90 days, you will need to apply for a short-term visa. Any program, which mostly will be the case, which is above 90 days, you will need a long stay student visa, and we will guide you through the process of that once you do get in touch with us with an acceptance. So once a student is done with his or her course in France, you are eligible to apply for a post-study visa. This is a two-year visa which you can use to search for employment opportunities in France. It's a one-year visa which you can extend for a second year as well. Anytime before 4 years, you can apply for this visa. And of course, if you are an alumni of a French university, you are eligible to apply for a five-year visa. It's a short stay, multiple entry visa granted for 5 years, which you can use to travel across the Schengen zone as well. So a student can, once you are done with your course in France, you can join the French alumni network in India. There's a LinkedIn page, there is a Facebook page, and of course, you can get in touch with us to join the network as well. If you are applying to a course, you can also reach out to the alumni of that university to understand the procedure that they went through to, and of course, go through how they felt the course was, and it just gives you a better insight on what you are applying for. Okay. Job opportunities in India. Now, a student, after you finish your course in France, you are eligible for the two-year visa in France. And this basically allows you to search for employment opportunities in France. But if you do choose to come back to India, you can, of course, apply for jobs in India as well. The French community in India is strong. There are over 1,000 French companies who are actively employing professionals yearly. So there are major companies like Decathlon, Renault, Dassault System, all of them, which you would have heard of. So you definitely can reach out to them. You can apply and for job opportunities with these companies as well. Yeah. So we will be taking you through the course, through the application procedures of to apply to public universities and private universities. There's a distinction in both of them. So we will be taking you through the application procedures of both in detail, just to give you a better insight on how to apply for certain courses. So Shruti will be taking over from here.
So we have a portal called the Études en France portal. So you can find this, you can find the login for this portal if you go to our website. There is a click login button over there. So you just have to log in and you will have to enter your personal details. Basically, you will be creating your account at this stage. You will have to enter your personal details and then click on create an account. And you will get an email to verify your account. So basically, this is to get your login details. The next step to access your account, you will have to go to the Études en France portal, enter your login details, your password. And basically, this is the screen that you will see once you enter your account. So there is you can see the first two buttons. So that is basically the difference in the application procedure. So your first is your I'm an applicant, which is if you want to apply to a French university. And the second is I'm a candidate. If you want to apply to, if you have already gotten an acceptance letter and you would be coming to us only for the visa procedure. There is also a mailbox where you can send messages directly to your Campus France manager. And yeah, so this is basically how the welcome page on the portal looks like. So yeah, like we said, there are two major procedures, the candidature procedure and the pre-consular procedure. So the candidature procedure is if you want to apply to French universities in France. And there are three main categories. So you have the DARP Blanche or the DARP White, which is for students who want to apply for a bachelor's or a licence program for the first year. The second category is the DARP or DARP, which means it's outside the DARP application. And this is if you want to apply for your second or your third year of a bachelor program, or if you want to apply to any other degree or a master's degree. And then you have the DARP Jaune, which is for programs in architecture. So for the DARP White, which is the licence, the first year of your program, first year of your bachelor's, you can apply for up to three programs. If it is the or DARP, which is your second or third year of bachelor's or a master's program, you can apply for around seven programs in one application. And if it's the architecture programs, you will be able to apply for two programs. So all of this can be done in one application, and it can be done, for example, if you're applying for a master's program, it can be seven different programs in seven different institutions, or seven programs in one institution. Basically, you will just have to do one application with all these programs. Yeah, so this is basically just to give an overview of the procedure. So first you will have to create your account and, you know, create your application and fill in all the details. And then you will have to submit your application and we will validate it from our end. This is basically, we will explain a little bit in detail about this in the next slide. You will then have to pay your campus grants processing fees, and then you will come back to us for an academic interview. We will then forward your application to all the institutions that you've applied to, and you will get acceptance letters, in the next few months. And then it will be up to you to make a decision on which university you want to accept. And then you will have to go to the BFS office for your visa application, and then it's the visa decision. So this is basically a flowchart of how the procedure works. So yeah, to go a little more in detail. Again, we come back to our welcome page where you have the option, I am an applicant, or I am a candidate, or applicant itself. You have to click on that if you are applying to a French university. So the next page is there are three sections basically. So the first section is your personal information. So here you will put in all your identification details. So your passport and passport details, your, you know, address and things like that. And the second part of it is your education qualifications. So in this part, you will upload all your education qualifications, right, from your 12th standard to what you are currently doing, your highest degree. And if you have done any internships or, you know, work experience or any courses which you feel are relevant to the program that you're applying for, you can put all of this in this section. And you will have to upload supporting documents. So your mark sheets, your degree certificates, in anything that is relevant to the course that you've done. And please make sure that the scans that you're uploading are clear, and it should be below 300 KB. So if it is not, then you won't be able to upload it itself. So yeah, so the next section is your language proficiency. So here you will upload anything related to French and English. So if you have done any French courses, or if you have finished the DAL for the DELP certificate, then here, this is the point where you will upload the documents, your certificates. Your English language proficiency, the proof for that would ideally be your 12th standard mark sheet. But if you have done an IELTS exam or a TOEFL exam, you can upload those as well. Yeah, so the next step would be to select the programs that you are applying for. So, and also make sure that once you're finished entering your personal information, you come back again to the applicant page, and it should appear as complete. If it is appearing as incomplete, then please go back into that section, and that must have been something that you would have missed out on. So just have a look at it and see what is the missing information and make sure that you fill that. So yeah, the next section would be choosing the programs. So you have to click on choose programs. And then you come to this page, which basically is your cart. So you can click on add program and select the programs that you feel that you want to apply to. So yeah, if you just have to enter a few keywords related to the program that you are looking for, and a list of programs, come right below. You just have to click on the option to, you know, expand a particular section, and you will see the list of programs under each domain. And then you click on the entry here. And the next thing would be to choose the campus that you are applying to, the institution and the campus that you're applying to. There is also a small column called View Program, where you can view the details of the program. So this gives you the admission criteria, the fees, and details regarding the program and who to contact, the contact person of the program as well. And then you just add the program to your cart. So you do this for all the programs that you want to apply for. For example, if you're applying to a master's program, you do this for seven programs that you would like to apply to. And then you will also have to enter your motivation. So basically, the motivation can be the same for all the programs if they are in the same domain. If there are programs in different domains, then you will have to change your motivation to make sure that it suits the program that you're applying to. But that is an option where you can click on choose the same reason for all the domains as well. So it depends on, you know, the courses that you are applying to. Yeah, so this is where you fill in the reason for your choice of the program, and then click save, and your program gets saved. And so this section is complete. So once you have filled in the details for all the programs that you want to apply for, you will have to save the document, and you have to save the page, and it goes back again to the applicant page. So again, make sure that it shows complete. Only once it shows complete, please go to the next section. Otherwise, it would not be possible to submit the document in that case. So yeah, so then the last step is to submit your document. Please check the box that all the information that you've provided is accurate and submit the applications. And please note that you can't make changes once you have submitted the applications. So it comes to us at this point. We will review your application and we will let you know if there are any corrections to be made in the documents that you've submitted. And so yeah, that is how we proceed. And basically after that, we send your applications to the French universities and you know they review it. Once they review it, they get back to us saying that these are the programs that you've been accepted into, and you get acceptance letters for the programs or depending on whether you've been accepted or rejected. And once you get letters or once you get you know a confirmation from all the institutions that you've applied to, then it is up to you to make a decision on which institution that you want to go for. So before this, we also have an academic interview before we send your applications to know more about your motivation for applying to a particular program. So yeah, basically after that is only the visa part of it. You apply for your visa and then it's the visa decision. So that is basically the candidature procedure.
Yeah. Moving on to the pre-consular application. So there are two ways that this application is created. One is after your candidature process, and the other is if you directly apply to a private university. So once you apply to a private university and they do send you an acceptance letter, you can create an account on the Études en France portal. You can click on I am admitted and you can move ahead with your process. I will be taking you through the process again. So just a small overview on the process. So once you do receive your acceptance letter, you can fill out the details on the application on the EF portal. Once you do that, you submit your file to the Campus France manager. We will take up your file, we will validate your application. And once your file is completely validated, we will send you a link for the Campus France fee payment, and as well as your academic interview date and time. So right now, the interviews are happening online because of the pandemic. So you will have to do an online interview with us. Once you are done with the academic interview, that is with Campus France, we will send you an NOC, which you can go use and go ahead with your VFS procedure, post which you receive a visa decision from the consulate. So that is the basic overview. I'll be taking you through in a more detailed fashion of all of these steps. So as I mentioned, once you do receive an acceptance letter, you have to click on Start Application for Student Visa or Pre-Consular Process, or it will also be written as I am admitted. So you click on that and that's where the application process begins for the pre-consular process. Yeah. So once you do select that, you will have to select the type of program that you are going for. Now, if your Indian institute is tied up or has collaborations with a French university and you're going for an exchange program, you can select you have been accepted to an exchange program. Or if you are going for a full-time degree, you can select that as well. So after you select the type of program that you are going for, you will have to fill in a lot more details of the program based on the acceptance that you have got. So yeah, can we move to the next slide? So once you do select the type of degree, you will have to search for the program in the catalog or on the portal. So you will have to click on search program in catalog. Search for the program that you have been accepted into using keywords. If the program is not mentioned in the catalog, you will have to click on program not in catalog and enter it yourself. So these are the two ways that you can select the program that you have been accepted into. Once you do find it, there are a few more details that you will have to select. So first of all, click on the program. Mention the course that you will be taking up, the campus where you will be situated. Once you do all of that, you will have to click on choose program and that gets added into your application. So once that gets added into your application, you will have to, of course, add supporting documents for the choice of the program. So you will have to upload your acceptance letter and of course your initial deposit fee payment, which you will receive from your institute after you pay the initial fees to block your seat. So this can be done by selecting to add a document, and you can browse your laptop, your computer, and select the documents. Make sure that the format of the document is fine, it's legible, and also it is below 300 KB, which is the requirement of the portal. This will just make the process a lot smoother. So after you have uploaded your documents, your supporting documents, acceptance letter, fee payments, all of those, you will have to click on save, and that gets added as your program that you are you have got accepted into. And after that, can we move to the next one? Yeah. Once you have completed the selection of the program, you will have to enter a few more details like you did for the candidature process. You will have to fill out personal information, which would include your name, of course, your address, your passport details, and a few other details which are mandatory. You will also have to fill out your educational qualifications. As Shruti mentioned, in the candidature process, that you will have to start from the latest degree that you have achieved. If it's a bachelor's, you upload your bachelor's completion certificate, your semester marks cards, move to the 12th grade, your marks for the 12th grade. If you are working, you will have to upload your work experience letters, all of them in order of what you have done. And once you have completed these three sections, so once you have completed all of these sections, you can go back to the application, and you can do this only when all of the sections is mentioned as completed. That is when you will be allowed to submit your application. So to submit your application, you can click on verify your application and submit. You can go through the details that you have already put into your application. And if everything is fine, you can go ahead and submit your file to the Campus France office. And please note that once you do submit your file, no changes can be made unless there is a mistake which we find on your part and we send the file back to you for rectification. Now, once the file is validated, as Shruti mentioned, once your file is validated, we will be sending you a payment link, which would be for the Campus France fee. We will send you the link as well as a date and a time for your academic interview. This will all be sent via email. Now, of course, initially the Campus France interviews used to take place in person, but now because of the pandemic, we have moved it to an online platform. So the interview will be online. You will have to carry with you a few documents that we will mention in the email, which we will need to verify your profile on the call. And once the academic interview is done, as I mentioned, you will receive an NOC from Campus France, and you can move ahead with your VFS procedure. Once you do complete your VFS procedure, you will get a visa decision, and that will be communicated directly to you. So this was the entire process for public universities and for private universities. Since we have reached the end of the presentation, we will take a few questions. If you all do have any specific questions for Campus France managers, you can also use the booth, which is a part of the portal. You can speak to them directly and ask them a few questions which you need clarifications on.
There is a question on how much do we charge for this. So that is a one-time payment fee, which is 16,500. So this, if you're applying to a French institution, that is if you're going to through the candidature procedure, even if you apply to 7 programs, it is just the 16,500 for the entire application. So it's not, you know, different fees for all your programs that you're applying for. So either procedure, there is only a one-time fee that we charge, which is 16,500.
Okay. Just looking for a few more questions.
So yeah, and also the Études en France portal, the procedure is for Indian nationals who are residing in India. So if you are not staying in India, or if you are a person from another nationality, then you will have to, you know, there will be a different procedure for this. So the Études en France procedure is, India is one of the countries who will have to go through the Études en France procedure. So it is for the Indian nationals.
Yeah, there is a question. The academic interview is only for private universities or for both private and public? The academic interview will happen for both, only in different steps of the process, which we did mention during the presentation. It will happen for both.
And there is a question regarding the admission, when the admission starts for public universities. So it starts on October 1st. Admissions for public universities open on October 1st for the next year's intake. So it goes on for around 2 to 3 months. So you can contact your Campus France manager and we will give you the exact deadlines for the admission procedure.
There's a question. How much time does it take to get the NOC? The NOC will be sent to you immediately after the academic interview.
And about whether the same procedure is valid for the exchange program as well. Yes, it is. So for your exchange program, you would have an acceptance letter already in hand. So like we showed you in one of the slides, there is an option whether you want to pursue a full-time program or an exchange program. So you just have to click on the option that you're going for an exchange program. Otherwise, the procedure is pretty much the same.
With regard to the procedure to apply for bachelor's, is it the same procedure? Yes. But again, it depends on whether you are choosing a public university or a private university, but the procedure for both remain the same.
And also regarding the level of French, you will need to pursue a master's in France. So if you're doing a program in French, there are several French taught programs and there is a catalog which is dedicated just for that. However, I think most of the institutions require at least a B2 or a C1. So it depends on the institution and their eligibility criteria, but usually it's either a B2 or a C1 that you need to have to pursue a program in French.
Okay. Just a few more questions.
Yeah, there is a question. If you already have the acceptance letter, is NOC from Campus France mandatory? Yes, so that would be your pre-consular procedure. So if you do have an acceptance from, and it's usually private institutions who have their own application procedure. So that's why you wouldn't have to go through Campus France. So if you get an acceptance letter from a private institution, you would have to come to Campus France for your academic interview and to get your NOC. So you would ultimately have to come through Campus France also.
If you are interested for the 2022 January intake, you can get in touch with your nearest Campus France manager and we will help you with the counseling and the different schools that are having an intake at that point. So you can write an email to any of the Campus France managers, the closest one to you, and they will definitely help you with that.
So if you want to know more about the scholarship opportunities for Indian students, there is a webinar which is dedicated just for this. So it starts at around 6:30. So you can, you know, log on to that and get a lot of detailed information on the scholarships which are available. There is also a question on whether, sorry, I lost it. You can apply to private institutions directly. Yeah, so for public institutions, most of the time you will have to go through Campus France, but there are certain institutions which have their own application procedure and who ask you to go through Campus France also. So, but it's usually you will have to go through Campus France to apply to a public university in France. And the admissions for that do open from October 1st.
There's a question which says, should one complete the French language course before applying? It's not mandatory because most of the courses which you will be applying for are 100% taught in English. So the prerequisites, there is no prerequisite of to know French, but it is beneficial for you for your life in France as well as for your employment and internship opportunities. Okay.
There is a question if you can join courses right after 12th. Yes, we do have a lot of bachelor programs which are taught in English. And we also, there is a dedicated webinar for the bachelor programs as well, which is happening tomorrow. So you can log into that to know more about programs which are offered for the bachelor's level.
Can we join courses right after 12th? There is a dedicated webinar for bachelor courses. You can definitely attend that and see and meet universities and ask them the questions about the bachelor programs that are available. Yeah, so it is, of course, possible for you to go for courses right after 12th.
There is also a question about how much time does it usually take to get an NOC. So usually after your interview, and if you don't have any more corrections to your file and if you've paid your Campus France processing fee, then usually after the interview, during by the end of the day, you would usually get your NOC if there are not if there is no other restrictions or something that you haven't shown during the interview. You usually get it at the end of the day, ideally.
Okay.
There is also a question on what kind of experience letter you need to submit. So if you're working, basically, if you're still working, you can also submit, you can submit your appointment letter. And if your company is willing to give you a service certificate, then you can submit that as well. If not, you can also submit your latest payslip if you're still working in the company. If you're done with that particular company, they would give you an experience letter or an experience certificate, which mentions the starting and ending date. So you can upload that as your experience letter.
If there are any specific questions to Campus France managers, you all can always attend. I mean, you can get answers clarified from the nearest Campus France manager through email, or you can also join the booth where you can talk to them on a one-on-one basis and get all of your doubts clarified. Okay.
The SAGIN program procedure is for public universities. So for private institutions, they generally have their own admission procedure and their own application portal. So if you want to apply to public universities, then you apply through Campus France. And yeah, that is why you can apply to around 7 programs if you're applying for a master's or the second or third year of your bachelor's.
Any more questions that
There was one question on whether the 16,500 is an annual fee. So it is the fee that you pay for your particular application. So it's not an annual fee. It's if you are applying to a particular program in a particular institution, then for your application, that is the 16,500 is the fee that you.
So if you all do have any more questions, the Campus France managers are available at the booth. You all can also join and attend the other webinars that will be happening today evening as well as tomorrow. So you all can also meet universities on a one-on-one basis to clarify all of your doubts about programs and the way the application procedure, the fees, the qualifications, all of it will be answered. So we have reached the end of this session. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining. You all can attend all of the other webinars that will be happening post this. Thank you so much again, and we look forward to seeing you soon.